गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम बैक टू योर क्लास 10th ज्योग्राफी क्लास। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू बी लुकिंग एट पार्ट 6 ऑफ द चैप्टर द क्लाइमेट ऑफ इंडिया। इन दिस पार्ट आई विल एक्सप्लेन यू अबाउट द साउथ वेस्ट मॉनसून सीजन एंड रिट्रीटिंग मॉनसून। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट विद द साउथ वेस्ट मॉनसून सीजन। द साउथ वेस्ट मॉनसून सीजन इज द सीजन ऑफ general rainfall. This season lasts from June to September. The differential heating of land and sea during the summer months cause the monsoon winds to draft towards the subcontinent. The large landmass to the north of the Indian Ocean gets intensely heated during April and May. This causes the formation of an intense low pressure in the northwestern part of the Indian subcontinent. Since the pressure in the ocean to the south of the landmass is high, it attracts the southeast trade winds which prevail in the southern hemisphere. These southeast trade winds affect crossing the equator are deflected towards the right because of the Coriolis force and reach the west coast as southwest monsoon. These winds bring heavy rainfall accompanied by violent thunder and lightning. This sudden violent onset of rainfall in the first week of June is termed as the burst of the monsoon. As a result of the tapering topography of peninsular India, the southwest monsoon winds divide into two branches. These are the Arabian Sea branch and the Bay of Bengal branch. Now let me explain you about the difference between the southwest monsoon winds. These are the Arabian Sea branch and the Bay of Bengal branch. Now first I will explain you about the Arabian Sea branch. It enters Indian landmass after blowing over a vast open sea. During this period, it collects lot of moisture. The total Arabian Sea branch blows over India. It beats against the western ghats as soon as it blows over the land. Whereas Bay of Bengal branch travels a shorter distance and carries less moisture. The Bay of Bengal branch partly enters India. Its major part blows over Myanmar and Thailand. It has to travel a long distance over land before it hits against the mountain. Now, distribution of rainfall received from southwest monsoons is largely governed by the relief or topography. The Tamil Nadu coast remains dry during this much season. This is because the Tamil Nadu coast is located parallel to the Bay of Bengal branch of the southwest monsoon. Further, it lies in the rain shadow area of the Arabian Sea branch of the southwest monsoon. I hope it is clear. Now, I will explain you about the retreating monsoon, which is also called northeast monsoon. The southwest monsoon starts retreating from northern India in early October. Hence, the months of October and November are known for the retreating monsoons. The reason of this retreat is that the monsoon through of less pressure becomes weaker and is gradually replaced by high pressure. The retreat of the monsoons is marked by clear skies and drop in night temperature. The land remains moist. The combination of high temperature and humidity gives rise to an oppressive weather. This is commonly known as October heat. Day temperature rises due to skies. Now let me explain you about the October heat. October is marked by clear cloudless sky, high temperature and high humidity. As explained earlier, this sultry and oppressive weather is referred to as October heat. It is a transition period between the hot rainy season and cold dry season. By the end of October or by the beginning of November, fine weather conditions prevail over the rest of the subcontinent. The low pressure conditions are transferred to the center of Bay of Bengal by early November. This shift of the low pressure area is marked by cyclonic depressions which originate over the Andaman Sea. Some of the cyclonic depressions manage to cross the eastern coast of Southern Peninsula, resulting in heavy and widespread rains on the coast of Tamil Nadu. These cyclonic storms move from the northeast to the southwest. The retreating monsoons are generally dry except on the Tamil Nadu coast. Retreating monsoon rainfall in some places is as heavy as the summer monsoons. Interior parts of Deccan remain dry because they lie in the rain shadow of the Eastern Ghat. So, all these were there in the retreating monsoon. Now the next is the distribution of rainfall. Now let me explain you about the distribution. The distribution of rainfall is determined by the following. First, the pressure and directions of the relief features. Second, the direction of the winds bearing moisture. Third, the cyclonic depression determined by pressure gradient. India can be divided into four rainfall regions. First is heavy rainfall region. This region experiences more than 200 cm of rainfall annually. It includes such area in the western side like the western coastal plains and the slopes of the Western Ghats. In the north, it includes Meghalaya Hills, the southern slopes of eastern Himalayas, Assam, Arunachal Pradesh and West Bengal. Next is moderate rainfall region. This region has rainfall ranging from 100 cm to 200 cm a year. The areas are the northern part of Andhra Pradesh, the southern part of Tamil Nadu, middle Ganga Valley, some portions of Western Ghats, eastern Maharashtra, Madhya Pradesh, Odisha. Now the next is the scanty rainfall. The rainfall in this region is varying from 50 to 100 cm. These areas are parts of the Deccan Plateau comprising the regions of Karnataka, Andhra Pradesh and Tamil Nadu, eastern Rajasthan, Punjab, Haryana and Kashmir. And the last one, the desert and the semi-desert region. These areas get the least rainfall, either less than 50 cm annually. These areas are northern part of Kashmir, southern Punjab and western Rajasthan. The rain shadow regions of the Western Ghat lie in the Deccan Plateau. Now let me explain you about the features of the rainfall. The main features are there is rainfall over 3 months and the rest of the year is mostly dry. 70% of annual rainfall occurs in the rainy season. The rains are mainly of relief type. The windward slopes of the mountains get more rainfall than the leeward side. Only small portion of the rainfall is received from sources other than the monsoon, like cyclonic rainfall and convectional rainfall. The quantity and the time of occurrence of rainfall cannot be predicted as the rainfall is erratic. It is because of this uncertainty that sometimes there are four floods and sometimes drought. India has an agrarian economic dependent on rainfall. As such, rainfall affects the economy of the country. Now it's over. I hope it is clear to all of you. Now read this chapter thoroughly and listen my lecture. Thank you. God bless you all.